Mark Almond first found fame as one half of the 80s pop duo Soft Cell when, of course, their version of Tainted Love became a worldwide hit. And he went on to enjoy further success as a solo artist, selling another 30 million records.
Fast forward a few years and Mark is about to tour the UK and celebrate, I don't know if I dare say this in front of you, 55th birthday?
55th birthday, yeah.
Happy birthday for Monday.
Thank you very much.
Wouldn't believe it. I will speak to Mark in a moment. First, let's remind ourselves of some... This is my favourite bit of the programme, when we show Mark Almond his best bits and hits. Here we go. Pink elephants I'd see, though I'd be drunk as I could be. I'd sing that song they sang to me about the time they called me Jackie. If I could be the angel's child, a little girl cried, the tears run rings around my eyes. Set fire to the house in my heart. We're gonna set fire to the whole. Gazing at the swollen mouse on concrete fields where grows no grass, he stumbles blindly on. Iron trees smother the air, withering, they stand and stare through eyes that neither know nor care where the grass has gone. Oh, I just love that.
I always have to laugh at the dancing. Yeah,
it's kind of
so enthusiastic, isn't it? It's so...
We were worried that Tainted Love wasn't going to be in the sequence.
Oh, no, I'm sure it will be there. But I'm absolutely sure.
Are you glad it's there? Because I read somewhere that you got fed up with it.
No, I don't get fed up with it. You know, I think you go through periods of your career where you kind of, I just don't want to hear it anymore. But I've long since passed that. And I always enjoy doing it. And I look at it as a kind of a theme song, in a way. It's, you know, I think I'm very lucky to have a couple of records, a few records that have been very big hits and the public really love, and that's one of them. So you've got to embrace it and love it, really.
How many years ago was that? Because you still, you know, walked through here this morning and it was on the radio.
About 30-odd years now.
Oh,
a long
really?
Time ago, yeah. It's still being played.
It is fantastic, isn't it? And it's funny, you know, you seeing it and, you know, us seeing it as well, because, you know, music can take people right back to very important parts of their life, and I guess it's odd being an artist and seeing, realising that, is it?
It is. Well, I mean, I tend not to try to be too nostalgic and look back too much, I think, because I always think it's good to move ahead and move forward. And you can get kind of stuck in nostalgia too much, you know, about your old sort of, oh, the times were good in the old days. But they're not. I mean, for me, my career has never been more exciting and interesting than it has been now, and there's so many different things that I'm doing. So I like being 55 because it's brought me lots of really interesting things to do.
You're not there yet. You're not there till Monday.
Well, I'm not there till Monday, so I'm still 54.
You're psyching up for it.
Yes, I'm psyching up for
and
it.
And you're
yes.
celebrating your birthday on Monday in a really special way, because you're basically showcasing that work.
Like every 5 years, I like to, most birthdays I ignore, but every 5 years I like to do something sort of special to say, well, I'm still here, a 5 year sort of kind
reminder.
Of marker, whatever. And so I'm doing a show at the Shepherd's Bush Empire in London on Monday, and I'm doing a bit of a special show because I'm doing some of my favourite songs, some fan favourites as well, and I'm ending off with a little Northern Soul set because I love Northern Soul, 60s soul music, so we're going to do a little Northern Soul set to end off the show with. So that's kind of, that'll be kind of interesting, I think. It'll be fun.
And then you're going to go on tour as well?
I'm touring in the autumn. I'm doing my Pop Troubadour tour. There was an album of singles to come out with it, but that's coming out next year now. So the tour is still going ahead, and that starts in September, throughout September. And I'm also touring with Jules Holland on and off at the moment as well throughout the year. So I've toured with Jules many, many times over the years, and this is one of his best tours, I think. And he's got, as well as me, there's Roland Gift doing some of the shows. There's Katie Tunstall, and of course, wonderful Ruby Turner as well. So
Oh, yes.
So okay. I've got a full diary at the moment.
I'm interested in this Northern Soul part of you that, you're letting out in the show. I mean, is that something you'd like to record again and release again?
I kind of wouldn't mind. I've thought about many times about doing an album of Northern Soul songs because, of course, I've had a couple of hits with Northern Soul songs. Things like Tainted Love, The What, and The Night, of course. And so there's many other songs in that genre that are fantastic, undiscovered songs. And I would love to kind of maybe do an album sometime because I love that kind of music. Sometimes it's nice to do an album that's a pure kind of dance pop album, and maybe that's on the cards for the future. I'm not sure.
But you're still so passionate, aren't you, about it? Do you write every day? How does it kind of manifest in your life?
Well, I don't write so much. I don't write so much songs now, but I enjoy what I do doing more than ever. I mean, over the past year, I've done opera and theatre. I've done some acting. I've got a film production company that I'm part of as well called Lab, and we've got a couple of films in production at the moment. Mm-hmm. So it's always very, very exciting for me at the moment.
You're a poet as well, aren't you?
Well, I've written sort of books of lyrics, I call them, more than sort of poets. I wouldn't call myself a poet, but I tend to not write so much. I do write occasional songs now, but I love interpreting other people's songs more than anything now, I think. So.
Oh, now, is this true? It was written for me this morning that you would like to sing with Cliff Richard. Is that actually true?
Well, I don't know. I mean, Cliff's, I think, fantastic, I think. I mean, you've got to give it to Cliff.
No, I'm not saying he's not fantastic. It's just
great.
Not something I would have put you two together.
I don't know where that kind of came from, really. Maybe a kind of off-the-cuff remark. But, you know, if Cliff asked me, it could be a kind of interesting combination, the kind of light and the dark, you know.
Yes.
We could kind of remake Devil Woman together or something and give it
the
a whole
dark
new...
Cliff Richard.
Which I think would be kind of great. I mean, you've got to give it to Cliff. You know, Cliff's Cliff and he's a national treasure and institution. He's brilliant.
If we see him here on Breakfast, which we do from time to time,
that would be the bizarrest coupling of the century, I think.
Fun.
It would.
I mean, he said himself, he just wants to keep performing and he's got no intention of giving up. You've said similar things, haven't you, that you'd have to be carried off the stage with a winch.
Absolutely. I'd have to be winched off the stage. I'd be on stage in a bath chair or whatever, you know, kind of Zimmer frame. And I mean, that's when I'm really happy. I love to be on stage and I love to kind of, you know, it's always that stage. It's a joke saying when I love being on stage that I act like I'm off stage even when I'm off stage. So it's kind of something like that. But it's I love performing and I love it more than ever because with being older comes more confidence, more kind of knowing what you do, knowing what you're good at, knowing what you're not so good at.
What are the audiences like? Are they kind of, you know, your older fans and then...
Very mixed, I find, these days. I find a lot of older fans that have been there throughout the years. You know, I see a lot of regular faces on the front row, obviously. But a lot of younger people, too, because with things like the kind of, you know, the internet and downloading tunes and things, and people explore a lot more on those downloading sites. You know, I'm not a massive fan of downloading sites because I think it takes the kind of love out of music in a way, and I grew up in a time with vinyl records and CDs, which I really loved, but in a way it helps people, young people, to discover other kinds of music and they maybe rediscover some of the bands that they like now who they've been influenced by, and I've hopefully influenced and inspired a few younger bands.
I mean, how many people have covered all of your songs? They've been covered all over the years, haven't they?
Well, many people have covered Tainted Love, certainly, and they've done so because of Soft Cell's version. I mean, it was a pretty obscure Northern Soul song when we found it, and people have kind of, it's had this life of its own that's kind of gone on, and many people have kind of covered Soft Cell's version of Tainted Love, really, I think, which is very flattering.
Nice. Well, listen, lots of luck with the tour and everything. Happy birthday.
Thank
on
you
Monday.
Very much.
You are obviously going to enjoy it.
And Mark's tour starts on September the 18th, goes all over the UK, and you can catch him before that, as he was saying, with Jewel Holland's tour as well.
That's all from us from today. We're back tomorrow when we'll be going backstage with the members of the rock band Kiss. We'll keep you up to date.